Hi, and welcome to our kids' workshop. We are taking that away. See, today we have made so we can, you can see what I'm doing. What we are building is a trebuchet, and it looks like this one. You can see. And we have that's a picture of it. I have it here on the table. You can see here. I just go back just to see if the sound is on this one. It is okay. So here it's on the table. You can see it's. It's alive and well, but it's. I will move the camera a little so you can see it, because the distance need to be there, and then you can see. That's how it is. And. But you saw that last time, or else you can go back through. Episode 8 and see what we did there. Now we will try to fix it like it was before. Like this, I think. Yes. Like this. So last time we talked a lot and didn't get a lot done because I had to explain a lot of stuff. So what we, when you see this, is this kind of scary because it's very elaborate, but don't do that. We take one step at a time. It's only a bunch of sticks cut in pieces and glued together. Look at it in that way, and if you follow along, no problem, you will end up having one of these, and it can shoot, I promise you. It could make a dent in the door. So, but first we will make the button frame here, and this is, as far as I remember, 60 millimeters long. And what we used was these, where are you, there are you, these sticks that are 9 times 9 millimeters square sticks. You can see when I turn it like this, I had to be used to the camera. But to be, so we cut these two, but to ensure that it's easy and that you get it all right from the start, the ground work are very important. Easy but important. So I have take this. I have taped to the table just. These are 1, 2, 3 pieces of cardboard, and then I have drawn these strokes on it, so you can see they are 60 millimeters long, and there. And then last time we figured out that we need some square sticks that was 8. That if you can see on this one, when you see it, we have these that kind of hold these two rails apart and the frame together. So, and they are cut in the same material as this, just cheap sticks that square sticks that we cut in 8. centimeters, 80 millimeters sizes. And we need 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 of those. And I showed you last time that we use a cut. I don't know what you call it, but I call it the cut box. But it's something like this. And of course now the camera are too far gone. And now we will see if we can do this little trick. We can. Then and the purpose of that box is that you can cut like this and in 45 degrees like this with a saw like this, and it has a white blade. That's so you have it's not wiggle too much. So, and then you know these sticks are not that precise, so try to arrange them so that they are all the same height. I will try here to cut 6 at once. So let's see, for 6, because there are room for that in the box. And then I also mentioned last time some of these guys here, these called tool mates, but just we are not contractors and building houses, so you can buy these one. I think they are cheap. I bought 2 others today and I gave 50 crowns a piece, that must be something $5 a piece. Maybe there are some out in the garage or something. We could hope your father or mother have some. Who knows? Perhaps. There is round corners on this table, or around edges on this table, so that's not, if you make a table, don't get one with a round. Everything is maybe I should do this before I do that. We will learn while we work. And see if I can find a piece of wood I can use. To clamp it down. It works. We'll use one of these small ones to you can see now I have, where are you? There are you. I have used this angle to be sure that they have the right. And then put them in here, and I have measured here. You can see I made a stroke in the first one. So, and now it don't drop to the floor. And then I have planned to hold it down with this one. Maybe it is a little too. No, it will work. And then we will use this one so it don't run around on the table like crazy when we saw. And then I will take one more of these. Just for ease of work to hold them together here. We can even do something like this. Then we are sure that it don't move around. So, and then I have lined the stroke up here, so oops, I will use this one too because they kind of run away. Yes. So. So, this saw was not as sharp as it once were, but now we have six of these we can use. If you are gonna buy some of these clamps here, then buy where the camera. You can see this is fine this way, but this release here is very small, so it's very difficult to release it when you have clamped it on. So it's easier with this one, the new one I bought, because you just press this one. It's very easy to do. And you can see they are longer, so it can take over a bigger piece of work. And so and if you don't put the tools back where you took it, then in a minute it will get very messy and you can't find anything. Even if it lay just in front of your nose. So we will try to do that. And sweep the now we should have first we do like this where do I have, see if I have my pop knife here, because this is probably what you will have to. And you can see there always be some but you can see they are nice cut in the ends, but this one you can see they are a little. There also is, if I cut it with the machine, I have a machine, but I will not use it because then I kind of cheat, because I don't think that everybody of you have one. So we will, and then I have a little announcement also, that is that from Monday next week we will send every evening Kids Workshop, but you can see the schedule on my site pixelfantasy.com, but it will be 6 o'clock like today, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, no Thursday. But not Friday. Friday will be an hour later, but else it will be the same, because then we can get this one finished and then we can start to. No, I'm not sure we can finish next week, but Christmas is coming. And now we will see. This is a little, but you can always, if you look at the end, oops, most of the time if you, the up there, the grain are turning the same way, you can see the grain are going this way in the end, then they should be the same size, because that's often how they cut them. And kind of so this, they are a little, that's because of the, but we will send them afterwards. That's because of the etiquette, the labels they were on them. There's a little bit of blue on them. So, and so, and so, this is just where the cardboard is glued together. See? And see? And oops, that was not that good. And we will close that. So you can see I'm using ordinary wood glue. So indoor wood glue. You can use outdoor wood glue too if you want, but I think indoor is cheaper. But and I have put it, I use a lot, so I buy in those big ones, but and then I fill it on a little one I have. And because when you had drawn this, now you knew all the stuff is in a right angle, if I could talk. And so we don't have to, it will not run around for you. So we start, put a little glue on here, but not too much. I will go and take a, where is that? Just a second. It will not get stronger because you use more or something like that. You just have to put enough on. That's the whole meaning of this. See? And then you start putting this, and then a little like that. And in a minute we have some kind of we take one of these. Adjust it a little. And now it's going anywhere. Take the one in the other end, and it's easier to handle. Because if there is too much glue on, then you will have the then you will have a not lot of glue under it too, so they will glue to the table and whatnot. Take one more of these ones. Come on. Yes. No. kind of a little fiddly before you get it. I will do like this, because then we have go away. Equal weight in both ends, because you can see this is this way and this is this way. If it was the other way around, it would tip to one of the side. So now be sure this is okay, and then we can take the middle one just for good measure. Because now you are sure when these are dry and okay, then everything is dried straight and good. It against the table, and it don't matter if it now it's on this cardboard, so it don't matter if it sits in it, it's kind of glued to the cardboard, because we will sand it afterwards. But I will of course and then you do it another way again. I will of course use put drawings up, or I will take a picture of this and then I will put measurements on it, so you can see where and how far it is from here to there, and so. So it is easier to make. And it is like this all the way through cotton sticks and two little. And glue them together. And I forgot last time I didn't tell you, but I guess you have figured that part out. You of course need a drill, but I guess most household these days have one of those. And if not, it's time mom and dad buy one. I'm telling you, they need it. And you do too. Or else you can go to your grandfather. He have one, I guarantee you. Most grandfathers have. Maybe even he have the time to help you. A little help don't hurt. Of course, it all depends on your age. Well, we have pushed it a little. to run away with this one. Oops. And then see, it's already glued to the cardboard. At least in one end. Down. See, now you have a frame. And as I told you last time, there will be a row, a stick over this too. But that we will get to when we get there. Now, see, what we can do now is we can make the slide. I will just move this around here. Now you can see. You can see there is a slide here. Can you see that? No, you cannot. But we can release the, whoops, shit. Sorry for my language. That was, it was not really loaded, but you can see already the mic boom took it. So you can see now, can you? There is a slide where this piece will slide in when it's loaded. It will go from this way. So we can make that one if we don't shoot ourselves before. Long enough? Yes, it is. We used two of these glued together. I put this one over here again. And as you can see, there's this label here that kind of leaves a... I don't understand why they have to put stuff like this on. Two of these together like this, and then I put another stick glue up on the, so we have a kind of a border, so it don't run out over the side. But how and .5, but you don't even have to measure because as you know, you have, it goes from the, can you see up there? Yes, it's, oh, I can see on the camera. Wow, a camera. They have a display on it. And then to there. So you can just say, and then make a mark. So we will take these one at a time because it's easier when there are only two. I will take I will hold this one against here. Normally, you will not stand with this up in the air. You will hold it on the table, but that's so you can see. So, we'll use our trusted clamps. And one in the other end. So, and we will remove this a little. And maybe you have, where you buy your paint when you are painting the living room or something, there they have so you sticks to. Sorry, sticks that you stir around in the paint. Bogart, maybe you can get a couple of extras there. Sometime you can be lucky. This time too. this. Oops. On the floor. They put the floor so far down nowadays, they are hard to reach. See? Now we have a couple of those. And we remove this. And a good piece like this, don't throw that away. Another day we're gonna need that. It's always good to have a box somewhere with a lot of that kind of material in. Then you can always find a piece of what you need. That's right. Then we will just glue the edge. Container than it is with a big one. Oops. Just beside the trash can. See? Shall we think that these are more or less dry? Let's hope. One of them are a little higher than the other one. So. But we will send that down afterward. So we forgot to make balance. I can't find the shoe for that one. So need to beam it out. Shouldn't that be good enough? I think. So we can move that aside a little bit. And this is not 100% dry yet, but enough to, so that we can, tomorrow it is more dry or better. But we can get I have a piece of cork, and I actually think you call it the same, but you can see what it is. The same thing they have in wine bottles, so, and that is good to sand, and one of these are very cheap too. And I know I keep saying stop or cheap, and then I say another and another and another, and sooner or later it comes up. But you need little tools. But you can use a wood, a piece of wood too. So. And then you take this side of the saw and say, don't do it in here, do it like this. Like this. And it's much cheaper to buy a roll than it is to buy these small sheets. But I don't know. Sometime. Careful, because it's not that dry. So you don't have any steps up. I take it apart before it dries, and it's easier when you can put a little muscle into it. So you have a fine letter now. So is long enough, because they don't have any more of it down where I buy this stuff. It is, see, kind of the rail on the slide. Okay. I will place this another over here while we do the other. Did I put my, see, okay, here it is. They are a little clumsy these to handle with in one hand. And this stick is 6 times 6 millimeter. Give it to me. And we need 2 in that size. Sorry for all of the noise. So, just use the other one as a measure. We cannot, because there are something like this. Now we can. But the size of the stick, it's all depend on what you can get where you buy the stuff. And nobody says that this one has to be 9 times 9 and this 6 times 6. This can be 10 times 10 and all that. It's you can you can go after what you can get, and then this just have to be a smaller one you can see the rail, the rail on the slide here has to be smaller, So if yours are five times five or four times four, that's okay. That's only because this is what I could get. With my guy in town. Hold with your finger when it's only such a little stick. So, well then, you just put one more clamp on it. So, it's possible to do it. So. And see the ends here need a little tidying up. So we see how this went. If I the only reason that I do it now is that we kind of try to do as fast as possible, so it's not getting too boring. You will probably take, if I was you, I will wait the glue, wait a couple of hours at least before you start to. Now I will make some noise here because if I sand with hand, it takes too long when we are through. I will take the sound off. So, I need some new sandpaper on this one. This took too long, but see, then glue this on the a little railing on here. See that? Of course. Then we have, and you can see there was none of this that was difficult or hard. Was that the camera? Yes. There was none of this that very difficult. And he was not using a lot of fancy tools either. So, and it is like that with the rest too. It's only a question for you to get the materials, and borrow or buy the tools we are using here. But if the money are an issue, then I'm pretty sure that there are a lot of people that would borrow or lend you theirs. Need some of these. And you can use your mom's clothespin for this. They don't. And if you absolutely want them to be, what is this, purple or something, then you can paint them. Of course, I'm only trying to be funny. Whoops! That can shoot too, you know it. So maybe we don't need to make it a trebuchet. We will try one more time. Maybe the purple was not that good, because these thin sticks are never very, very straight, so you need to. Then we need another one. Because then tomorrow I will take some pictures of what we got done today, with some measurement on it. And I know that some of you are using inches and that kind of thing, but and are not using the metric system, so, but you can use the Google browser to do it. by millimeters in, and then it will come out like inches in the other end. Sorry. My pneumonia will not disappear. And I could see to kids making each one of these and then have wars. And maybe we should make a fort so one could shoot at. But see, now this is finished. Then we have finished two things tonight. See? And next time we will start to build the towers, or what we shall call them. See, it's not that difficult. I know you think when we come to the round one then we get in trouble, but we are not getting in trouble. I promise that we can do it. But I guess the time is up, because I have I have another show here where we make stop motion movies. But that's a whole nother ball game. Kettle of fish. No. But if you have any questions, any suggestions, any comments, any something or another, then please go into pixelfantasies.com, and there you can find Kids Workshop, and up in the bar up here. Whoops. Yeah, in the top. Well, we cannot do it from here, but pixelfantasies.com, that's very easy. This is this one here. That's hard to see on this one, but maybe it's easier there. Maybe it's easier here. Yeah, you can see it there. It's spelled like that. Pixelfantasies.com in one word. And on that side you can find drawings, and tomorrow I will take some pictures of this, and then I will put some measurements on it, and so you can see how to do it. I will say thank you and thanks, and remember, from Monday we are on every single day during the week, except the weekend, because I need to have some days where I can prepare stuff. I need to come up with some new stuff, and I hope you will help me with that book when you comment on it. So thank you, and hope to see you again. Hi.